Okay. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Township Committee meeting of February 28th, 2017. Ms. Borick, please call the roll.
Committeeman Bruchette. Committeeman Delcor.
Here.
Committeeman Thompson. Deputy Mayor McCauley.
Here.
Mayor Sirachi.
Here.
Administrator Pereira.
Here.
Attorney Willard.
Here.
Please join me in a salute to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now that is an enthusiastic pledge. Thank you very much.
Please be advised that in accordance with Section 5 of the Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231 of the Public Laws of 1975, that notice of this meeting was made by the posting on the bulletin board at the Hillsborough Township Municipal Complex and notifying the officially designated newspapers that this meeting would take place at the Hillsborough Township Municipal Complex at 7:30 p.m. February 28, 2017. We do not have any minutes to approve, so we're going to go right to reports from committee liaisons. Committeeman Delcor.
Thank you, Mayor. A few items this evening. First of all, a save the date note for our Economic Business Development Commission. We're going to have our first business social of the year. It's going to be held on April the 19th at Roycebrook. Stay tuned for more details, and if any businesses that would like to sign up, it's one of our two or three socials that we do each year as a networking for our local businesses. You can sign up through our HBA e-news at hillsboroughbusiness.org, and there'll be more information coming in the over the course of the next month or so. In addition, from the police department, Chief Powell has asked me to remind residents that there is a medicine drop box located in the lobby of our police department. Over-the-counter and prescription medication should not be disposed of down the drain. Wastewater treatment facilities are not designed to remove pharmaceutical compounds, and they may end up in local waterways and may eventually be found in drinking water. So properly disposing of unwanted and expired prescriptions and over-the-counter medications promotes a healthy water environment and prevents accidental poisoning and intentional abuse. So if there are any pharmaceuticals that you would like to dispose of, you can drop them off there. There's also additional information at the New Jersey Consumer Affairs website, which is www.njconsumersaffairs.gov for more information. And additionally, there is a, we have the onset of potentially stormy weather over the next day or so. Residents are reminded not to drive around any road barricades or through standing water. The barricades are placed there for safety purposes. So I think anyone that's been here for any period of time knows we do have certain areas that flood. We've become a bit of an island, so if there's a barricade out there, please do not go around it. Turn back around and go the same way you came, because there is the road's barricaded for a reason. There's probably enough standing water that you can't pass with your vehicle. The Fire Safety Board, the Hillsborough Board of Fire Commissioners, held their election on February the 18th. Mr. John Lazarchek was elected to a three-year term to serve as fire commissioner, and all four of the questions that were on the ballot also passed with affirmative vote. Part of that is the annual budget that the fire commissioners put in place. That also passed again this year. There is a banned clothing drive through the Board of Ed. On Saturday, March the 4th, the Hillsborough Band Parents Association will be holding a used clothing drive from 10 a.m. till noon at the front entrance of the high school off of Raider Boulevard. Additional information will be in this Friday's e-newsletter. And finally, just a note on the EMS RFP, for those of you that either saw or heard some of the discussion that was held at the last meeting, we are still in the midst of reviewing the bid response from the RFP. Due diligence is ongoing. There's no action that's expected to be taken tonight, but we do have an additional give or take 4 or 5 weeks before the response period and the decision on the bid must be completed. I think we have till April the 8th or somewhere thereabout to make that decision, 60 days from the end of the bid when we had the responses in. So certainly opportunity for further due diligence and discussion, but just want everyone to know that there's no decisions pending at this point. That's all for me, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you. Deputy Mayor McCauley.
Thank you, Mayor. Good evening, everybody. A couple notes from me. Finance Department wanted to send out a reminder that the last day to license your dog is tomorrow. So if you do have a dog and need to get the license, please come in to visit. Wednesday on the 1st is the deadline. As of the 2nd, a late fee will be applied. It's a $5 late fee. So please, reminder, come in and have your pets licensed. The vaccination is valid through October of 2017 in order to renew the dog's license. From the Board of Health, save the dates. Robert Wood Johnson will be conducting a blood drive here at the complex on Wednesday, March 15th from 1 p.m. until 6:30 p.m. To register, you can call RWJUH Blood Services. That number is 908-685-2926. Or you can also register online at their website, is rwjuhdonorclub.org. A reminder, the American Lung Association is supporting a Lung Force Walk at Colonial Park in Somerset on May 20th at 8:30. There's a load of information on their website, very good information regarding lung associations and what they do and what they're about. So they are holding their walk again at Colonial Park. For more information, it will also be in the Friday e-newsletter. A couple of things from our Recreation Department. A save the date for the annual run around the park will be held on Sunday, April 23rd at Ann Van Middleworth Park. It's a fun recreational run, so if you want to get started out there in the spring weather, come on out, register by March 31st, and you'll receive a free t-shirt. You can also visit the recreation website to register for that run. Spring soccer and softball registration is here. It is right around the corner, believe it or not. Warm weather this week kind of shows that, but the spring soccer and softball league registration deadlines are both on March 10th. Soccer leagues are open to children ages 3 to 12. Softball leagues are open to grades K through 8, and full information registration, again, also available on the township website, recreation website. Summer camp registration, we always have a great turnout for that, so please be sure to register. It begins on Friday, February 17th. Camps are for 5 to 11-year-olds here at Auton Road School and Amsterdam Schools. Camp for 12 to 14-year-olds will be held at Hillsborough Middle School, and the tiny camp for 4 and 5-year-olds will be at Hillsborough Elementary School. Again, the camps begin Monday, June 26th, and run for 8 weeks right through August 18th. Information will be available again on the recreation website. A reminder, our credit card advisory team is together, and they're accepting grant applications for the first round of grants for 2017. For those of you unaware, they can the Affinity Credit Union here holds a card for Hillsborough. You can register and receive a card, and it goes back into the community for any nonprofit organization, senior or youth organizations. To apply, you can get up to a $2,000 grant funded through this program. Completed applications must be done by Friday, March 10th, and the administration office here. You can drop it off or go online, I believe. Is it online, Pam?
Yes.
And it's also online to be considered for the grant funding. To date, Hillsborough program has rewarded over $60,000 back into communities. A lot of our Boy Scouts, seniors, and nonprofit organizations really reap the rewards from this. So please, if you're interested, let us know. I think that's it for me this evening, Mayor.
Okay.
Mayor, you just want to let people know they can kind of pile in if they need to a little bit.
Yeah, you can come in.
Here, come on in. Don't have to stand outside.
Mayor, there's some seats up here in the front. If folks want to come in, there's some space up here. You're going to have a seat.
Okay. Thank you, Deputy Mayor.
Welcome.
So I've got a few announcements this evening. Just first, quickly, a pinch hit for Committeeman Doug Thompson, liaison to the Wildlife Management Commission. They held their reorganization meeting couple of weeks ago, and just want to congratulate Bob Matros for being named again as chair, and also Mark Kirby as secretary. And they will be doing a presentation to the township committee probably sometime in May over the overview of this past winter's hunting season. So looking forward to that. Next, got to meet with Cub Scout Pack 389. They were working on their Arrow of Light requirements. One of their requirements to fulfill, to earn that Arrow of Light, is to meet with a government official, ask a couple of questions about government, and also kind of gave them a quick tour and overview, you know, of our operations here. So hopefully it was a good time had by all. They looked like they were smiling. So so just remind, you know, if there's anyone else that is looking to earn that, by all means contact the front office to arrange a visit. I also had the opportunity to go to Triangle Elementary School to meet with Ms. Root's class, third grade class. They had just finished their unit on government, and they had invited me in to, again, give them an oversight of what we do here. And they definitely, they asked some very interesting questions. So I think one of them wants me to run for president. So. next, April. April is National Volunteer Month, and once again, it's time to celebrate and honor those who decide or who dedicate their time and talent to be stewards and leaders within our community through their generous volunteerism. Nominations and recommendations can be made by completing the online form. The deadline for submitting is March 31st, and we will be recognizing those volunteers at our April 25th meeting. And then if some of you check your smartphones, you will see that we now have free Wi-Fi that's available here in the complex. Okay. We will note that as one of our major accomplishments of the year. So you can access, obviously access online, view data, whatever you want to do while you're visiting here. So.
Yeah, but isn't it adults only, though?
Okay. Next, we have a scholarship competition. I know that's this last time, but just wanted to remind again that the Lewis Bay II Future Municipal Leader Scholarship Competition is now open, and it will be awarding three $1,000 scholarships statewide. The deadline for submitting your application is March 10th, so that's coming soon. Completed applications need to be sent to my attention here at the Township Municipal Building. Additional information regarding the scholarship opportunity can be found on the Naviant site, which for those of you who are, you know, that's utilized by our school district. In addition, you can get additional information on their scholarship from the guidance department at the high school. And lastly, as we always like to remind everyone, is how to stay connected with everything that's going on, to even see some pictures and videos from this evening. You can do it via our e-newsletter and Twitter account, and I hopefully on the back, if you don't get the Friday e-newsletter, we have cards to fill out just with your email address. And we also have TV29 for those of you that have Comcast. All our meetings are broadcast, and we also have a YouTube channel to showcase our meetings and also our, as I like to call it, our semi-reality TV show called Hillsborough the Good Life, and we are in now season 3, right? So chances are you'll probably see yourself at any one of our events, maybe make it on to our next episode. And of course, for traffic and emergency notifications, we now have a what's called Swift Reach 911, which replaced Nixel. So just and the Honeywell system. So please make sure that you are signed up on the new Swift Reach 911 system. And that's all the announcements I have for this evening. So I have a feeling most of you here are for some proclamations. So we have a few to go through this evening. What I do ask is when you do receive your proclamation to please return your seat until everyone's had and received their proclamation. And then we promise we will pause let you go home. If you want to stay, you know, more the merrier, but we will not be offended if you feel the need to go home. Particularly, I think there's a lot of students here to maybe do some homework. No, no. Okay. So, starting with our first presentation this evening is from our Clean Communities to the Central Jersey Stream Team. Through a grant funding available from New Jersey Clean Communities, we're able to make this donation to Central Jersey Stream Team to be used for future projects within Hillsborough Township. And at this time, I'd like to invite our Director of Public Works, Rich Resavi, who's also our Clean Communities Coordinator, and along with Jens Riedel, President of Planning and Grants for the Central Jersey Stream Team, for the check presentation. And Deputy Mayor?
I'm a very lucky guy. I have been able to hold several directorial positions in town, starting with Parks and Recreation, then moving to social services along with that, and now public works. And through that, I've come to realize what great volunteers that we have in town. And, you know, since I rarely have an audience, thank you for all the parents that are here with your kids, because I'm sure at some time you were part of recreation. So thank you very much. Just one little opportunity that I get. And now with public works and being the Clean Communities Coordinator, we get to do some pretty cool stuff. And Jens and I met almost by accident. These guys send out some pretty neat information about cleaning up streams. And I'll let him speak on that. But it's people like this that help keep the environment the right way. And it's really appreciated by everyone.
Thank you, Rich. And thank you to the committee for the donation. We do a lot of work in this area, and it's nice when the towns help us with the trash disposal. That's a big expense to us, but when we get some extra funding to cover some of the other costs, that's even better. So for those of you that don't know the Central Jersey Stream Team, we started in 2013 cleaning the Raritan, and we've done now, in the last 4 years, we've cleaned from Clinton all the way down to Piscataway. So the whole, or most of the South Branch and a good part of the main stem. Last year we had about 15 cleanups, which is our usual for these years. And last year we pulled out, the metric that we use is tires, basically because they're easy to count and they're easy to find usually. So last year we pulled out about 1,150 tires out of the river, and in the last 4 years, it's close to 4,300. So things are getting better, but there was a lot of work to do, and we're still continuing that. We're a 501c3 nonprofit organization, so any donations that we get are welcome. Everything that we do is volunteer only. We don't have any paid employees. Everybody has a regular job. So we do this in our spare time on the weekends and the evenings. Just for some of the events that we have planned, on March 11th, we're going to be down in Griggstown along the Millstone floodplain. On April 22nd, on Earth Day, we're going to be along the Green Brook between Middlesex Borough and Bound Brook. Then we have another one planned for May 20th, which we're still confirming the location, so we don't have that yet. And then we're going to have a bunch during the summer and into the fall. And what we do differently from other groups in the summer, especially on the Raritan, since it's fairly shallow in the summer, we just take our canoes out there. We basically walk along the water, walk in the water, and pull our canoes, and that's where the trash goes. So, like I said, we're going to have several other events in the summer. We're looking at sections of the South Branch between South Branch Village and where the North and the South Branch come together. And then we're also looking at a stretch along the main stem, kind of near Duke Island Park and south of there. Because even though we've done those sections, we always find as the sediments shift around that we keep finding new stuff. So we keep returning to the same areas also to repeat those, in addition to hitting some new spots that we find out about. But again, thank you. It helps a lot when we get extra support from the towns, and it's appreciated.
Online, Central Jersey Stream Team.
Okay, next we have a proclamation for Christina Simons. You could join us here, and also any school officials. Because I see a couple. All right. Whereas Christina Simons has received the honor of Hillsborough Middle School Teacher of the Year for 2017 for her dedication and service to the Hillsborough School District. And whereas Ms. Simons is a literacy teacher on Team 8B at Hillsborough Middle School. And whereas Ms. Simons has been a member of the Hillsborough School District faculty since 2002. And whereas in 2006, Ms. Simons established and continues to direct Hillsborough Middle School's Shakespeare Society, where students perform the works of William Shakespeare. And whereas Ms. Simons' creativity, passion, and dedication makes her a hero to both her students and colleagues. And whereas Hillsborough Middle School is proud to have Mrs. Simons as their Teacher of the Year, now therefore be it proclaimed that we, the Mayor and the Township Committee of Hillsborough, further commend Christina Simons for being recognized as Hillsborough Middle School Teacher of the Year, and we thank her for all her work and dedication to the youth of Hillsborough. Signed by the mayor and the members of the Township Committee. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Testing. There we are. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, members of the committee, so much. Hillsborough has very much become my second home and my second family in a lot of ways since I started teaching here in 2002. And it is very much because of you, and I actually see at least one former student of mine in the audience, and it's making me feel so grievously old. But besides that, it fills me with such a sense of pride and fulfillment to be here with you and be a part of this family and this community, because it is such a glorious, beautiful family. And I am so very much indebted to Dr. Joseph Trubolsky, who is so humblingly brave and patient to humor so many of the ideas that I have. Very much like my husband, who the other day said to me that the three most terrifying words that come out of my mouth are, "I was thinking," because it means that there's something else that I feel that I need to do. And Dr. Trubolsky has entertained so many of these whims, and for the most part, they have been successful, and I hope that they continue to contribute, and I continue to contribute to this world that these guys here are probably the best part of. And I know I just ended a sentence with a preposition, and the literacy department is going to hate me for it, but sometimes it's not so much the quality, but the content, and what great content we have here. So thank you very much.
Okay, next we have a proclamation for Nicole Shahinian. Whereas Nicole Shahinian has received the honor of Triangle Road Elementary School Educational Services Professional of the Year for 2017 for her dedication and service to the Hillsborough School District. And whereas Ms. Shahinian is a speech and language pathologist at Triangle Road Elementary School. And whereas Ms. Shahinian has been a member of the Hillsborough School District faculty since 2008. And whereas Ms. Shahinian can also be found behind the camera, recording and directing video productions at Triangle School for both students and staff. And whereas Mrs. Shahinian is described as a talented, devoted, selfless, knowledgeable, and kind advocate for her students, as well as her colleagues. Whereas Triangle School is proud to have Mrs. Shahinian as their Educational Services Professional of the Year. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that we, the mayor, and the Township Committee of Hillsborough further commend Nicole for being recognized as the Triangle Road Elementary School Educational Services Professional of the Year, and we thank her for all her work and dedication to the youth of Hillsborough. Signed by the mayor and the members of the Township Committee. Congratulations.
I truly appreciate this honor. It is my great pleasure to work at Triangle School and inspire the children to be passionate about communicating and expressing their great creativity that they have. We do a lot of movie productions, and it's been my great pleasure to work in special education and serve the community. Thank you so much. I guess we can guess what's next. All right, I'd like to invite up here, but slowly, the Auton Road Intermediate School Teams 5J and 5K. Come on up. Auton Road Intermediate School's teams 5J and 5K held their third annual Super Bowl, in which the students were asked to bring in cans to be donated to Hillsborough Township's Community Assistance Network. And whereas both teams learned a true lesson of giving back to their community,
by gathering and donating an astounding 2,214 cans of soup for charity. And whereas, while both teams showed superb sportsmanship in this friendly competition, in the end, everyone was a winner for giving back to their community, Team 5J Falcons were the 2017 Super Bowl champions, collecting 1,284 cans. Now, here comes the tough part. Whereas the teams 5J and 5K are comprised of the following students and teachers.
Gianni,
Sarthak,
Drew,
Alex,
Max Romanek,
Goss Wasserman,
Vincent Capitano,
Nick,
Sam,
Michael,
Neil,
Riel,
Gabriella,
Nathan,
Arjun,
Sam,
Brendan,
Victor,
Nick,
Sage,
Charlotte,
the other Gabby,
Megan,
Amelia,
Artem,
Sabrina,
Kara,
Mary,
Sophia,
Ellie,
Mason,
Ayush,
Jason,
Matthew,
Maddie,
Mackenzie,
Allie,
Valeria,
Amanda,
Owen,
Jordan,
Lily,
Marcus,
Julian,
Danella,
Cameron.
Thomas,
Carly,
Gabriella,
Aaron,
Katie,
Talia,
Now, therefore, be a complaint, be proclaimed, proclaimed that we, the mayor and the township committee of the Township of Hillsborough, do hereby commend Auton Road Intermediate School Teams 5J and 5K's teachers and students, along with their parents, not only for initiating and supporting this food drive, but for the students being great contributors and amazing sports throughout. They are a great example to the youth of Hillsborough Township. Signed by the mayor and the members of the township committee. Congratulations to all.
We'd just like to thank the mayor and the council very much for recognizing not only the students, but also their families, because obviously we couldn't have done this without you. Thank you so much for giving them such a great model of community support. So thank you. Right there, and I need you to say, on the count of three, we're going to say Hillsborough, the good life, okay? Ready? One, two, three.
Hillsborough, the good life!
Everybody look to the right. Okay, now look to the middle. Okay, now everybody look to the left. All right, hold on. Before you, does anybody in the back want to come up?
Yes.
All right. All right, guys, one more minute.
Okay, we're going to take a 5-minute break. You're free to stay, but we're not going to be insulted if you want to leave. So thank you everyone for coming out. Okay. Okay, we're starting. Okay, we do not have any new business at this time, so we'll now open up the public comment on matters not on the agenda. If there's anything you'd like to discuss, please come up to the mic, state your name and address for the record, please.
Good evening. Michelle Eilbacher on Wolverton Lane.
I'm sorry, which?
Wolverton Lane.
Thank you.
I would like to ask the Township Committee to consider the idea of a governing organization or committee to oversee many youth sports programs in our town. I've done a lot of research on this over the last few months. There's a need for such an organization for several reasons. An oversight committee could offer consistency among private town organizations. It could share resources and provide support system to better educate our coaches and our volunteers. It could provide consistency in certification, fingerprinting, and background checks. Not all town programs do this. It could provide oversight to organization finances. Embezzlement in youth sports is rampant and all too common. There's a lot of data to support this. It could provide an appeals committee, and it could protect players from unnecessary abuses of power. The top problems in youth sports today, adults not letting the game belong to the kids, coaches and leagues failing to respect kids and the sport. Youth sports programs often serve the adults, not the kids. Self-regulation is not the answer. Most operate with no oversight at all. This leads to a lack of accountability, and that only the kids suffer for this. Currently in Hillsborough, all of these problems exist. Too many times we hear parents say they didn't sign their child up because it wasn't fun anymore. So they just quit. Or parents take their kids to other towns to play because the town organization abused their power. so the kid no longer gets to play with his town friends. I can provide many examples of this in Hillsborough. Most of our town organizations don't hold open meetings. They don't have any financial accountability. They don't have term limits, which kind of leads to the good old boys club. Our Parks and Rec Department has a system of checks and balances. As time has gone on, the Parks and Rec Department has given other private town organizations control over a variety of sports. So more and more unregulated organizations are taking control over youth sports in our town. These volunteer mom and dads can be in control of hundreds of thousands of dollars with no check and no balance. There is no transparency among our town organizations. Try to find a budget for most of these town organizations. They don't exist. And when asked, they can't provide. These private town youth organizations may have eased the burden for Parks and Recs, but it should not be a hands-off duty. They need to do more than just oversee field use and permits. Parks and Recs need to be more proactive, need to go in there, and they need to make sure that people in charge understand financial management, insurance, and offer proper training. They have a duty to monitor organizations that are providing services on their behalf and provide acceptable standards. They need to act as unbiased mediators. Our parents have nowhere to turn when one of these organizations abuses its power and acts like a bully. Sadly, many of these examples exist in our town. Parents should have a better venue to deal with these situations. We need to create a system where these organizations are held accountable. I have tried to come up with ideas on how to tackle this issue. One idea I had come up is that a town rep serve on private boards and at meetings, where they could both monitor the organization's operations and act as a place where concerns can be vetted. Another idea is creating a board with one member from every organization, as well as town reps. This board could hold open meetings throughout the year. We just need to be more diligent in protecting our young athletes. We owe it to them to make youth sports fun again. It needs to be more enjoyable, and I realize this is a huge undertaking. However, I think our kids deserve it. You saw many of them here today, and I think they deserve it. And if we all work together, I think we can do something. Just want you to consider it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Michelle. Yeah. Appreciate that.
And I can certainly relate, because I've had a couple of daughters go through youth programs too, so, and going even up into other organizations. So it's not loud enough. Sorry. So, but I know there probably would be some legal hurdles for some of that, but just going to kind of ask, Mr. Farrar, if you could maybe get with our director to see what opportunities there might be, because I know we do have some shared services with some of those organizations, particularly.
Sure, absolutely.
Fields.
I wouldn't mind meeting with you and Mr. Wagner as well from our Department of Recreation, our director. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Anyone else would like to comment on any items not on the agenda? Seeing none, we will now move on to, you're in luck. No public hearings or introductions of new ordinances. So we will now move on to considerations. Okay. Consideration number one, resolution authorizing the tax collector to complete an application to participate in the electronic tax sale program and submit same to the director of the Division of Local Government Services. This is the third year that the tax sale has been done electronically, which is not only a more efficient method, but also provides a larger pool of potential investors, which ensures that most unpaid taxes and municipal charges to the township will be collected. And I know I have spoken with our CFO on this, because it allows opportunities for people from out of state to get involved. So I've seen its success. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Any additional comments from the dais? From the floor? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Commander Zelkor.
Yes.
Deputy Mayor McCauley.
Yes.
Mayor Sorachi.
Yes. Consideration number two, resolution authorizing the execution of a contract with Schilke Construction Company, Inc., for emergency repairs to replace a 60-inch culvert at 79 Wartsville Road in an amount not to exceed $33,500 plus $250 per week for the rental of temporary steel plates for their proposal dated February 10th, 2017. There exists a need to replace a culvert at this location, and it is the only means of ingress and egress for this property. May I have a motion?
So moved, Mayor.
Second.
Any additional comments from the dais? From the floor. Seeing none, roll call, please.
Committeeman Delacour?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor McCauley?
Yes.
Mayor Sirachi?
Yes. Consideration number three, resolution authorizing the purchase of a 2017 Ford Explorer from buyer Ford in an amount not to exceed $25,985.50 through New Jersey State Contract 883013. For this resolution, as well as for the next one, these funds for these purchases are provided through the Recreation Trust Fund. The funds for this trust are derived from monies collected for all of the recreation programs sponsored by the township. They're used to pay for any expenditures that would enhance the program offerings, as well as overhead expenditures to run these programs. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Any comments from the dais? From the floor. Seeing none, roll call, please.
Mayor Delacour?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor McCauley?
Yes.
Mayor Sirachi?
Yes. Consideration number four, resolution authorizing the purchase of four soccer goals for use in recreation programs from BSN Sports in an amount not to exceed $8,850. May I have a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
Any comments from the dais? From the floor. Roll call, please.
Commander Delacour?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor McCauley?
Yes.
Mayor Sirachi?
Yes. Consideration number five, resolution ratifying confirming an agreement with Shane Doyle Farms, LLC, for the winter 2016-2017 sidewalk snow clearing services. Shane Doyle Farms provides sidewalk cleaning during snow events as part of the shared service agreement with the Board of Education. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Any additional comments from the dais? Floor? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Committeeman Delacour?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor McCauley?
Yes.
Mayor Sirachi?
Yes. And that's all the considerations for this evening. We are moving on to the consent agenda. May I have a motion to approve this evening's consent agenda?
So moved.
Second.
Any comments from the dais? From the floor. Roll call, please.
Committeeman Delacour?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor McCauley?
Yes.
Mayor Sirachi?
Yes. Next, claims list 2017-04. May I have a motion to approve the claims list?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Any comments from the dais? From the floor. Roll call, please.
Commander Delacour?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor McCauley?
Yes.
Mayor Sirachi?
Yes. And believe it or not, this concludes our regular meeting for this evening. However, we do have an executive session. Just a small one. Ms. Burke, please read the resolution.
Whereas Section 8 of the Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231 of the Public Laws of 1975 permits the exclusion of the public from a meeting in certain circumstances, and whereas the Township Committee is of the opinion that such circumstances exist, now therefore be resolved by the Township Committee of the Township of Hillsborough, the County of Somerset, State of New Jersey as follows. Number one, the public shall be excluded from the discussion of the hearing after specified subject matter. Number two, the general nature of the subject matter to be discussed is as follows. Litigation, Hillsborough Town Center versus the Township of Hillsborough. Two, Hillsborough Properties. Hang on. Thank you. Three, affordable housing. B, contract negotiations. One, Mountain View Park. Two, Hillsborough Baseball. And C, land acquisition block 177, lot 55. This is ruining my record of speed reading the resolution. I apologize. Number three, the Township Committee may take official action on those items discussed in the executive session upon the completion of the executive session, and the minutes of those discussions shall be made available to the public as soon as the matters under discussion are no longer of confidential or sensitive nature. Number five, this resolution shall take effect immediately.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
May I have a motion to approve the resolution?
So move that, Mayor.
Second.
Any comments from the dais? From the floor. Roll call, please.
Commander Delacour?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor McCauley?
Yes.
And Mayor Sirachi?
Yes. And we will now move into executive session. Good evening.